So yeah, the first one is a little bit more of an everyday look. The second one, definitely not an everyday look for most people, but very, very festive. And then here we have the wintry. The wintry, sparkly, shiny look. Well, hello my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video where I'm going to show you three looks and give you my thoughts on the newest Nomad palette called Home for the Holidays. She's very, very nice, sparkly and festive, like me. And if you're new, welcome, my name is Nikki, I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love makeup just as much as I do, if you want to be inspired by unusual color combinations, if you want to see and hear about brands that no one else is talking about, and if you are slightly orcish, like me, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, so we can all play in the snow. Or not. I love snow, what can I say? I hope that I can make a snowman this year. Yes. And if you don't like snow, that's fine. Send it my way, because I love it. But that's not why you clicked on this video. Let me explain the slightly orcish. It means olive. If you are an olivey, then you are basically orcish, Shrekish. Kind of like that. Yes, but today I am going to show you three looks give you my final opinion on the latest palette from Nomad Cosmetics called Home for the Holidays. Can we just appreciate the artwork? It's so nice and sparkly. Let me also show you the inside. Now, unfortunately, mine was a little bit... My black shade is a little bit dented. It's not terrible. I can still use it. And I tried to clean up the palette, but I kind of failed. So that's why mine is looking a little bit dirty. But that's all okay. Let me also show you the swatches before we go any further. And as you can see, it's a very, very sparkly palette. One matte and the rest are shimmers. To be very, very transparent up front, it's not a palette that I usually use on its own. But I do know that a lot of you are very, very excited about this and do love all shimmer looks. So what have I done? The first look is a look just with this palette, but I'm using the black as a transition shade, so you have a little bit more of a definition. Then the second look, I pulled in another palette to just show you that you can use it as an accent palette, and that one is more basically, I don't know, Christmas inspired. And then this is the last look, which is a little bit more winter inspired, and I wanted to challenge myself and do an all shimmer look. So I did. So yeah, those are the three types of looks. I will leave the timestamps down below in the description box for you guys to check out. I received this palette in PR and it launches today, the 16th, and all the launch details will be listed down below for you guys to check out. Yes, I have an affiliate code in case you want to save some money. It's Nikki10, it will be listed down below as well. And I will also link where you can find the palette. I will show you the three looks, and then at the end of the video I will give you my overall impression about how the palette performed and yeah, if I think it's worth getting or not. Without further ado, grab a drink and a snack, put your feet up, pull on your mittens and your hat and your scarf, even if you're living in Florida, and enjoy, because here comes look number one. Okay, look number one. I am going to set my eye base a little. Just on the top part. Just with the face powder, doesn't really matter. Well, I have one matte, so I'm going to go to the black. Just gently. I'm going to follow my bottom lid up. And in. See what happens there? That's basically the guide. And I'm just looking down and basically following the line in a little bit. But not all the way. Just like that. I can see it's a very pigmented black, but because I don't know... Wow, I cannot talk. It's early. Because I can't... Wow. I don't need a lot. That was what I wanted to say. I also haven't done underneath my eye. So I can... foundation-wise, so I can clean everything up if I want to. Initial placement. I'm going to grab a fluffy blending brush, a hint smidgen of black. So I'm dipping my brush in lightly, and then I'm actually swiping it off on the towel that I have here. So I have a minimum amount. Oh, Okay, I want a hint of the black. So again, with that very open brush, I'm grabbing a little bit of black, then wiping it off on a towel. Because for me, what I've noticed is that if I'm working with black or another very, very dark color, it can get away from me pretty quickly. And I want to keep this a little bit lower, so that's why I'm doing it this way. I want this a little bit softer. Okay, I'm going to build up the crease a little, just with the same brush, but now I'm going to tap it lower. And as you can see, I kind of have that diffuse line already. So I can just concentrate on building it up. Now it's time for the shimmers. I am going to keep this one shape-wise pretty simple today. I am going to start with the shade called Kaiser. Okay, it's a little bit of a particle-y formula, but that's okay. This is dry and I have quite a bit of fallout. Okay, I'm going to spray. And how do I do that? I load up my brush and then I spray the brush. Still fallout though. I don't know, I feel like it's almost a little bit prettier if it's a little bit looser. Next shade I am going to go to, I wanted this a little bit more back on top here. I could clean up my lid, but I didn't. And that means that the more I pull it back and on top of the black, the darker it will become. Let's go next to the green. Am I though? No, I'm going to go to the purple. I'm tapping it off, also dry. It's a very, very nice purple. Now I want to make sure that the blend between the two is nice. I'm just going to go to that first shade and I'm kind of going to pull it over a bit. Cleaning my brush in between, just on a microfiber towel. Okay, I have my blending brush here that I used. I'm going over the edges. Sure. Okay, so let's grab the green called Fur Babies. I'm going to spray. And then I'm going to go to the purple. Because even though you cannot mix green and purple mattes, you can mix green and purple shimmers. Because it's different, they blend differently. And a little bit of the black in the outer corner. Okay, and what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do the rest of my face. I'm going to clean up the fallout. And how do I clean up the fallout? I will tell you. I'll grab a little bit of face primer, and that is what I use to clean up the fallout. So let me do that, finish off the look, and then I'll be back and show you how it came out. I finished off the look with my baby doll lashes in style 723. Lippy is just a gloss from Lethal. Well, that's not what it's called, but it's a gloss from Lethal Cosmetics in the shade Nova. I ended up putting a little bit of that yellow shimmer called Family in the inner corner to kind of, you know, add a little bit of extra something something. And then that is it for look number one. Let me know down below what you think of it. And let's get ready for look number two. I have already primed my eyes and I pulled in another palette. I actually pulled in their America Sparks palette. And I'm going to start with that one because I want to do green in the crease. So I'm going to start with the greens. You can start with any shade that you like. You don't have to start with this particular palette. But if you want to recreate the look that I'm going to do, you kind of need at least a green matte. So yeah, doesn't matter from which palette though. Okay, so I'm going to start with the lightest of the green. Yes, very lightly. Next, I'm going to go to the darker green, which is this one. And again, it does not matter what palette it is, as long as it is a darker green. And this is one more of a bluer green. I'm just very lightly going to place it on top of the lighter green. And a little over, because I want it more also along the lines of a foresty green. You know, that Christmassy green. Then I'm grabbing a very, very fluffy brush and I'm going to blend the layers together. Okay, then I'm going to go to the palette. I'm going to go to the black. I'm really stretching my eyelid up because I don't really want any skipping. And then when I look forward, yeah, that's the placing that I want. Cleaning my brush. I'm actually going back to the first brush I used. Very lightly go over it. I'm also putting a little bit more of the darker green on top of the black. Yes. I am going to go to the red shimmer called Friends. I love a red shimmer with a passion. I'm going to spray it. Tap off a little bit of the excess. Oh, well, yeah, look at that. Oh, this is a very, very pretty. Oh, this is a stunning bright red metallic. Wow. So I'm looking forward now. I'm just going to, with that red shimmer, do something funky. It could be that I need a magnifying mirror for it, but I want to make sure that I can see it with my eyes relaxed. I'm going to go back into that darker green from the other palette. Let's see if I can place a line just above that red shimmer, just on the border. Basically kind of like a cut crease idea, but then also not really. Okay, now I kind of want to make sure that the lighter green is a little bit nicer. A little bit, a tiny bit blended. So, okay, and because it's a Christmassy look, I'm going to go to the green shimmer called Fur Babies. I'm just going to put it on top here. Or shall I do? No! We're not going to do Fur Babies, we're going to do Family, which is the green, the yellow. Yellow gold. So I'm going to go to the green Fur Babies, the shimmer. I'm just going to put it on top here. Just lightly. To get a little bit of the sparkle. I'm going to go back to the black. I'm stepping it on the outer corner. I'm kind of making a Santa hat-ish thingy. Not really, but I'm going to name it something. Okay, I'm going to go to the bottom lid now and I'm going to do a trick that I learned from my friend Debbie, and I will link her channel down below. Her channel name is Debutant. She uses her mattes wet underneath her eye, and I tried it and it is just amazeballs. So I'm going to go to the dark blue shade, a dark green shade. I'm going to put it on my brush, then I'm going to spray the brush and I'm going to put it underneath my on my lower lash line. We actually used to do this back in the day, but it really helps against fallout and it makes sure that they stick all day. It also makes them more intense, and especially on the bottom lid, a lot of the time We have already set there, right? So yeah, you want that same intensity. This is the trick, honestly. And dry your brush off in between so you don't go into the shadow with a wet brush. And also, if you feel that some of the mattes are maybe a little bit lackluster, you can always do this to add a little bit more oomph. Now, let me put on a red eye pencil, finish everything off with liner lashes and something in the inner corner, and then I will be right back to show you the completed look. I thought, let's go all out. So I did. I put in a red eyeliner from Catrice. It's technically a lip liner, but I use it as an eye pencil always. And I also used a red lip liner. And on top of that, it is a gloss from Unique Beauty in the shade Ruby, which is a red, as you can see, duh. Falsies are from House of Lashes in the style Iconics. This was the second look of the video. One more look to go and enjoy, because here it comes. The last look, and I'm going to go out of my comfort zone. I'm going to make it largely shimmer. So I probably will pull in the black matte, but just to add a little bit of depth on top of the shimmers. So what I'm going to start with is glitter glue. Wow. Yeah, I'm not really awake yet. I'm going to go to the blue called Buzz. It's kind of, the plan is a little bit more of a wintry feel. But I'm going to do a halo. So I'm just going to press this on very, very well so that the primer is really saturated with the shimmers. I don't really care about the fallout because I can clean it up anyway. I'm going to go more in, as you can see. Just going to basically leave the center open. That is because I'm going to make definition probably with the matte. I'm still kind of lining it up with my bottom lid because that's prettier for my eye shape. Okay, and I'm going to do the same underneath my eye, but also a little bit of glitter primer. And I'm just going to stamp that on my lower lashes, or just below actually, on my lash line. And with my eyes relaxed, I'm just making sure that it all connects. Something like that. Okay, and then it's time for the white, which is going to go in the center, and the white is called Evander. Wow, that's pretty. I'm not really one for white shades, but white shimmer shades, but it is very, very pretty. Okay. I'm going to grab a tiny bit of the blue, fade it in, and then a little bit of the white, and basically fade it out. So this is what I have so far. I don't want to add a little bit of the white in the center, just to make sure, a tiny bit, just to make sure that it is really popping. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to make a little bit of definition with the black. So I'm just grabbing a small brush, going to go to the black, and I'm going to make it a little bit darker in the inner and outer corner. And I am pulling it to the end of that blue shade. In the beginning. Also going to do that underneath my eye, and I'm also going to make sure that it just fades slightly. So I'm cleaning the brush. I'm going to basically blend it a little bit into the blue. Ooh, Ooh, that transforms it very, very nicely. That's pretty. I am going to go back to the blue though. Just tap my brush in. And just make sure that it is still blue, that you get that gradient, you know? Okay, I want a little bit of extra blackness in the outer corners. Just in the very, very, very end and inner part. So just placing it and then kind of fading it in on both sides. Now, if you want kind of a happy wintry look, leave it like that. But yeah, apparently I'm not in that mood today. Who knew? I'm also going to connect basically a light darker line right underneath my bottom lid, because I find that pretty. Now, I have to redo it probably when I clean up my face, but still, you can at least see that I did that. I need that part up a little bit higher. I'm grabbing the blue just on a fluffy brush, because I need it up a little bit higher in the outer corner. Very, very shiny and sparkly. Yeah, huh. What do I think of that? I don't know yet. I'm going to finish off everything for my inner corner. I haven't decided yet. So I'm going to clean everything up, finish everything off, and then I will be back to show you the final look and give you my opinion on this palette. Just a tip, if you want to clean this up, grab a little bit of face primer on a cloth like that, yes, and then clean up like that. So you basically use that primer to gently wipe away the excess underneath your eye. I finished off the look with a white eye pencil, and falsies are from House of Lashes in the style Iconic, and the lippy is from Essence. It's a hydrating nude in the shade Heavenly. Let me give you my thoughts on this palette. Now, when I saw the outside, I was like, oh, that's so nice and sparkly. When I saw the inside, I was like, dang it, it's an almost all shimmer palette with one matte. If I'm being completely transparent here, I have said this on numerous occasions, I am not an all shimmer person. Why is that? Because I don't usually have the time to use multiple eyeshadow palettes. I remember that back when I started and my collection was smaller, I used to do my makeup like that. And I still do it sometimes when I am able to, but usually, especially when I'm filming, I am not someone who picks, I don't know, four different palettes. It's just not how I do my makeup. Also, all shimmer looks is just not something that I do often. It's just personal preference. Performance-wise, the shimmers performed very, very well. I do feel that there are kind of maybe a little bit more of different finishes in here, because the red is just so, oh my god, that red. I think it's my favorite red shimmer that I have in my collection. Yeah. And looking at the swatches that I have here on my arm right now, I can see that the red is extremely shiny. Also the white, but that's the nature of the white. The blue is very nice and popping. The purple is a little bit more, I almost want to say a little bit more muted, but that could be, let me do it like this, that could be the nature of the color. I feel that the pink and the orange are maybe a little bit more muted, and by muted I mean that they are not extremely over the top foiled. Now, my perfect shimmer formula is more along the lines of your old school formula. Why? Because I feel that that is very, very pretty on especially textured lids. The look that I have today, I feel like, especially, and that's the nature how it is, but this white is very much protruding, so I feel like I have bedroom eyes today. Kind of feel like my cat, because one of my cats has wonky eyes. It's all okay. I do really like how this look turned out though, so I think that I hope at least that I showed you some variations in the video by using the black as a base in the first look, then the second look pulling in a different palette to basically use this as an accent palette. But I also wanted to show you that you can just do an all shimmer look and then use the black, if you want to darken up. Now, you saw the difference, right? If I didn't use the black, it was very nice and it was very popping, it was very 90s, it was very winter, and now it has just a little bit more definition, it's a little bit more grungy, so that is how you can use the black. I am actually very happy that she put in the black, because honestly, if you're going to use this as a companion palette, especially if you have a lot of colorful eyeshadow palettes, a lot of colorful eyeshadow palettes don't have a black in them or a white. Not in my collection, at least. There are some who do, but I think it's very fun that you could even, if you're like, I don't know, I just want to have a brown as a transition shade, grab a bronzer. Use that as your transition shade, go in with the shimmers, and then you have a black to deepen up and grungy up the happiness of the shimmers that is that are in here. My final judgment, I think that the quality is very, very nice. I think that the shimmers are extremely pretty. I think also that the black is very pigmented. It is a good black to work with, though. Basically, this is going to come down to preference. If you want a very, very pretty, fun, holiday, sparkly palette, then this is the one for you. You know, outside sparkly, inside sparkly. If you are like, yeah, this is not for me, then this is not for you. And it doesn't matter what I say. It could be the bestest quality in the world. If this is not something that you want to use, then it is not something that you should buy. Does that make any sense at all? Yeah, you can create some very, very cute looks with this. And as an accent palette, that is it for me. It's an accent palette. I think it's very, very cool. If you want to buy the palette, I do have an affiliate code. It is Nikki10 and it will be listed down in the description box as well. And yeah, that is it. I will leave my Nomad Cosmetics playlist on the end screen for you to check out. And if you've made it this far, leave me Santa. Or Mrs. Claus, or the Christmas tree. So leave me basically a Christmas emoji. It can also be a present. That's also, or a snowflake. Something wintry, something Christmassy. Let's go with that. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to leave a comment down below, because it helps me out tremendously. And I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you, I think, Friday for another video. It could also be Thursday. Thursday or Friday. For 10 makeup products that I love from brands that bore me basically to death. So yeah, if you want to see that, make sure that you are subscribed. And I will see you then. Yes. Have an amazing day. Bye, guys.